And so this is the thumbnail drawing I did before. I'm about to make this painting of this bird, of which is should be a link in the description box to his the reference photo I used. And this bird is called Golden Finch, this species, and he's not a super common species around here. I think I've seen them before in New York. But it's not as common as, like, we have a lot of sparrows and even cardinals. The last video was of a cardinal. Anyway, that's the thumbnail drawing. Okay, so I'm going to begin this painting with a paper towel method of just, I'm going to cover up this whole canvas with a tone. And just have some raw sienna. And it thinned down a little, dipped in a little medium thinner. Thinner. Just, if I want, maybe get the bird in its general placement in there. Really just want to cover the whole canvas with a tone. Cerulean blue hue. Not going for ultra precise, obviously, because it's just loosely covering that up with a tone. And introduce a little darks as well. It's a little ultramarine blue. And I would say burnt sienna, but I have burnt umber already on my palette, and I'll use that. This thing is bird standing on that thing. Lifting out some paint, the heck of it. Bring out where the lights are a bit. So this paint shaper tool. This one's like a cup shape. These small size paint scrapers, whatever they're called. Paint shaper, really. And, I guess a fairly new tool, not really new, but from like the 90s, I think, when these first came out. getting general placement. I'm not trying to do anything too precise yet on this. I'm ready to begin with some brush work. Let's continue to try to get the whole big shape of these things going. I'm just noticing, I just mentioned it, that this particular brush is about this, it's a flat bristle brush, but it's really quite worn out, but it's still soft, and as long as it's still soft and subtle, I don't know what you call it, just it didn't, like the paint hasn't dried in, into it and like hardened it. As long as it's so soft, you can keep using it, and I even like trim off. After a while, the hairs start getting shorter, and you can just trim off some of the hairs, and it gets a little bit smaller than it used to be. But it works still good as long as it's soft, as I'm trying to say. I want to lift off the paint to get lighter sometimes. Also, you know, I'm adding white paint, of course, to lighten it. Or in these early stages, you can, I want to just lift paint off if I want it lighter sometimes. It's getting really off. Probably should concentrate on the bird shape more than background at this point. Fuck if I get it. Oops, pause. For the record, this tool is called a color scraper, not a, no, color shaper. Shaper. It's for the record, because I think I call it paint shaper. But it's, anyway, it's called a color shaper, I guess. And sometimes if it's not lifting the paint off, maybe dip it in a medium, and then it scrapes out that, lifts that paint right off. Obviously, I was saying it lifts the paint off as long as the paint's a little bit wet. Can't leave it dry overnight or something and still probably lift it off. I guess that's. Hope that's obvious. Because this is oil paints, by the way. I guess you. Well, whatever. I'll be quiet for a while. And concentrate instead of talking. And I start holding a number of brushes in my left hand, not the hand I'm painting with, but my left hand is holding several brushes so that they're different shapes for different like colors. Maybe it's a light color and dark colors, warm and cool, and different size brushes. I'm just holding them in my hand. So I can switch fast or something, I don't know. Just mentioning that. As soon as I say about how I'm using, I am still holding a bunch of brushes in my hand, but now since then I've just been using one brush and wiping it off a bit to change the colors too, you know. So now I can switch to other brushes in my hand as the background color appropriate for the background on there already. Take a little paint off my palette. dark, and Swedish chef. Thank you. photograph has really nice detailing, really nice crisp, sharp reference photo I'm working from. Kind of makes me want to get just do more like highly detailed finished thing, but and this is, it's going to be finished, but I'm going for a fast a la prima style painting on this. I think I'll do videos of more in the future. Maybe I could do some more videos of more detailed, more detailed paintings or something. I mean, detailed or more polished or something, layered. But we're gonna try and get this just a nice fast style on this. Have everything in it and call it done when I feel done with it. Hopefully it's getting the point where I've just about at least done what I think I can do with this. It is in a single session. Daily painter, fast painting. Alla prima. At this point, I'm trying to just call it done or something. Don't want it to look unfinished. Look good, of course, obviously. Thank you. Yeah, it's about done here. My battery's running out anyway. Camera battery's running out. It's just hard to draw, pull myself away. Be like, okay, that's a Alla Prima painting already. Stop. I think enough said. Don't just ruin it. Well, I'm not gonna ruin it, but maybe. I mean, just keep it maybe kind of understated. And that's like about enough already. Oh, I wrote my name, one of the corners, top left, top right, bottom right, I put it on the top right, I'll put my whole name. Oops, I messed it up. My P nicer, my E nicer. Peter and Shiro, what do you know, Peter Shiro? Well, thanks for watching, and if I were you, I'd subscribe or something, and like the video if you liked it. Subscribe for more wonderful videos or whatever. Put that a little square. There it is. We'll call it a painting, I guess. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.